I'm getting a snack.
No, you're fucking not. Oh my fucking God. You guys, whoever the fuck is watching this right now, I'm so fucking sick of Andrew's shit. I can't take it anymore. If the snack thing becomes a consistent bit, I swear to fucking God, if he comes out with a fucking granola bar, I'm gonna go over to his apartment and I don't even know. I'm gonna light it on fire. I'm gonna light your apartment on fire.
Oh, you're gonna light my apartment on fire? You're gonna light my apartment on fire yourself?
I'm literally light your apartment.
Oh, I'm just gonna light my apartment on fire. Oh, yeah. Oh, I guess you're coming over. Oh, apartment's going up in flames now, I guess.
I'm not even giving I'm not even gonna give you what you want, and that's for me to laugh, so.
Well, I also want attention, and you're giving me that. Checkmate. No, Grace. Grace! No, Grace, I'll finish the snack bit. No more snack.
Okay, I'm back.
No! Okay, I'm done. Wait. What if I eat the snack quietly to myself and don't make it a deal and we can continue the show?
Okay, sure. That, I guess, works for me. You can't eat it, like, weirdly seductively, though. I don't like that at all.
I'm so excited. I won. Okay,
how about we get into the show? This is The Riff with...
Andrew.
And?
What? Oh, Grace, yeah.
Hey, guys, welcome back.
I got more spice this season. Have you noticed that?
Yeah, I don't know if I'd call it spice.
Before I was your whole pet, like, and you're
I don't know what
and you go, bad dog. Now I'm a hound. You gotta give me some respect.
The show's been going on for like 3 minutes now. I don't want to talk about one real thing. I don't even know what's been said. Nothing's been said. It's been 5 minutes now and nothing's been said.
I think we got them hooked though. Because I was looking at the analytics of our last episode. And yeah. 11% of people made it to minute 4:30.
So, whoa!
Yeah. If we could get that number to, 25%.
Boost?
We got to give them energy, yeah.
Hey, guys, if you're watching this right now, oh, my gosh.
This is what they want.
Okay. Are you guys engaged yet? Are you guys engaged? Are we engaging you? Keep going, Andrew. I think it's working. Keep going. Harder. Like you want it.
Yes. Yes. This is why people come to our podcast.
You're so good at this.
Now that we got your attention.
Now that we have you hooked. I had a lot of people hooked this week on TikTok.
Oh,
that's right, guys.
You remember our TikTok sagas from past season?
Yeah. Not to brag, but one of my TikToks went low-key viral.
Let me brag for you. It went high-key viral. TikTok, ever heard of it?
Yeah.
Tell us more.
Yeah, it has almost like 200,000 views. Lots of likes, so many comments. And also, I just like to say, all the comments are like so positive. Everyone's like hyping me up and just boosting my ego. And I'm like,
I'll be Grace, you be commenter.
Okay. Oh my God, Grace, you're literally the queen. You're so good. Yes. Stop. This is the one. This TikTok, this is the one. Guys, we found it.
Okay. Subscribe for more. Say.
They keep saying this TikTok is the one. They're like, this is it. So, yeah.
I'm happy for you. You deserve it, Grace. And keep putting the work in. More will come.
Thanks, Andrew. Now, I know you had some exciting news to tell me.
Oh, yes. My bathroom news. Yeah. So I was talking to the roomies. You know, we got 3 roomies, 1 bathroom. That means we could do some investments into our general bathroom comfort and experience. And, you know, for each one of us, it's not too bad. So we invested in a bidet. Oh, yeah. Got that little water stream streaming up, hitting the butt hole. We bought one. It was $42 on Amazon. We paid extra, $8 extra for a lady feature to wash female genitalia. Because we were like, you know, we got ladies coming over.
Y'all got bitches. We got
different needs.
Am I right?
Yeah, we can spend a little extra dough on the side for them. So we have it. I installed it myself. Pretty easy to install. And it's pretty epic. I'll say that.
So how was it when you used it for the first time?
It was scary. But once I got used to it, it's pretty nice. I was like, I actually giggled when I first used it. I was like.
Really? Did you name it?
Because it was... Have I named my bidet?
Yeah.
Yes. The missus. The missus. That is my exciting bathroom news. Stay for more. But we can't dilly-dally. We have important
dilly-dally
business to get to.
Very important business. Yeah.
We have a very exciting comedian join us today. Join us all the way from India.
India!
Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Mehr!
Hey guys.
Thank you for joining us, Mehr. Where in India?
Delhi, like the main part.
Oh, very cool.
How's it, how's it hanging there?
It's good.
Pandemic.
Sorry?
How's it hanging there during this pandemic?
It's good. We couldn't go out of our houses in the beginning because it was a total lockdown, but now, like, the leader doesn't give a shit, so we're just hanging.
That's nice. Pretty cool. But unfortunately, you're not in Westwood right now for us, but you're coming soon.
I'm coming soon. I'm coming in January.
That's exciting.
Yeah.
Are you living here? Like, are you moving here?
Yeah. So I'm moving. I'm not moving there. I'm going for school, and then I'm gonna come back in the summer. But I'm moving in with my best friend, and I'm very excited because she has a car, and it's gonna be amazing. And my birthday is in Jan too, so I will be in LA in Jan, which is gonna be fun.
Drop some happy birthday messages in the comments below. We know it's not now.
Okay, guys. I know the conversation is going crazy right now.
Yeah.
So stop the Twitter chatter for 1 second.
And yeah, we're going to need to happy stop. Yeah. Just, you know, pause the video, go downstairs. Hey, happy birthday, Mehr. Then come back. Thank you for doing that, commenters. Let's talk comm. Joined the stand-up department. You haven't done other departments yet, right?
No, not yet.
Not yet.
I've been meaning to do digital though.
Ooh. You should come to sketch too. That's where I usually go.
Yeah,
sketch is a
Grace hasn't been coming. But we'll put that aside for now. Stand up. So you first started going last school year, and you went a couple times, and I remember you doing great right off the bat. You had funny stuff, good material. I was like, these are good premises. And that's rare to see someone coming in for the first time to like a lot of people, they write stuff and they perform it, but to go, that's really funny. That's a good sign. And it was clear early on. So very good. And then you went like twice, then took a break, and now you've been coming back regularly. Is that right?
Yeah. So, I basically came for like most of the meetings in the winter quarter, and I performed twice. Huh. I performed the Sexpert show, and like that was my first time like actually being good at performing in front of like a large audience. And then I took a break because stand-up shows were at like 5 a.m., 6 a.m. India time, and I couldn't for like the entirety of spring. But then after like summer was over, I was like, I can't not do comedy anymore just because I miss it so much. Like every day I was like, why am I not doing comedy right now? And it was just like the most annoying thing that I wasn't doing it just because of like time difference. So I just decided to start waking up whenever it is, honestly. Even if like stand up was at like 4 a.m., I'd stay up or wake up because time is not a thing for me anymore.
And you've been doing that regularly, which I don't know how. I couldn't do that.
Who goes to you?
Thank you.
Truly. Truly. That's a great sign. Because you got to love it. You got to really love it. And you do. Especially stand-up. But stand-up will kick your ass. And you gotta really like it.
No, some people, it's just kind of like...
People just comes to them. And they stamp on stage and people go, they're awesome. I like them.
They're awesome. Everyone just goes, you're super good at that.
Do you do stand-up, Grace?
What'd you say?
Do you do stand-up?
I started stand-up this quarter. Mm-hmm. I recognized me from one of the meetings, or maybe you were watching a show. But I just started. It has been a journey, Andrew will tell you. Many moons of trying to get me to the meetings, but I kept flaking. But now I'm not, except tomorrow I actually can't go to meetings. Because I have a valid reason. I promised a friend that I would feed, walk, and dog sit. So, like, right when meeting starts. So.
Oh, my God. I love dog sitting, though.
Right? It's so nice having a furry friend. It's
the best. In, like, the winter quarter, I was just walking on campus, and this professor comes with, like, the cutest golden retriever. And my friend and I were like, hey, if you ever want us to dog sit. And she was like, sure. Give me your numbers. And I was like, what? And then she literally let us dog sit her like cute ass golden retriever for like an entire day. It was amazing.
That's clutch. Cool. Do you miss being, I'm sure you do, campus? How long have you been home? Like, when did you go back?
I went to New York in March because my sister lived there. And then both of us together came to Delhi around like March endish. And I haven't been out of the house since then. And I'm getting a little bit frustrated being at home. But...
I mean, I was getting frustrated being at home after like 3 weeks. You've been in this John for like 7 months.
Yeah, I literally feel like I'm back in like high school. I feel like everyone feels that way, but I just don't know how to explain it. I just like don't see anything different. Like I'm studying in the same places I used to study. And I'm like, this is not happening right now. It's too much.
Well, at least you can look forward to January.
Coming around the corner.
Yeah, I'm very excited.
What got you first into comedy? What are you like, oh, comedy's fun?
I've always been interested in writing, but I realized that I was a little bit funny because people laughed at me, like my friends laughed at me, and I was like, maybe this is something that I should be doing. And also my sister was just like, suggested that I should do stand-up because I keep doing bits. I just thought that was my personality, but I guess like I do bits and like voices apparently. Uh-huh. And I was like, okay, maybe I'll give it a shot. And I did. And I just fell in love with the fact that I was talking and people were looking at me for like 3 minutes.
That's funny. I've been wondering this, do you have comedic aspirations? Do you want to make a career out of it?
Yes, I definitely do. Actually, I like recently decided that I don't want to be like doing English because my major is English. I realized I don't want to be like,
I was in English, but now I'm American Lit and Cultures, but like same thing.
Yeah, same thing.
What did you want to do instead of English?
I wanted to play English. I want me or Grace?
You.
Okay. I wanted to do English, like I want to be a writer and like publish like poetry and stuff. But then I realized that I'm gonna have to like be around people who are like really into English, like my entire life I do that. Like professors and people who are really into like Shakespeare and shit. And like, yeah, fine, but also like that's not fun. Yeah. And I also started like being into comedy more, and I like after my first performance actually. I was just like, this is it. Like, I just knew for some reason that like, this is what I want to do. And like, I know it's like unrealistic to want to be a stand-up comedian right after college, because that doesn't happen. But I definitely want to do like internships at like podcasts and like maybe like shows like Conan or like Daily Show, mm-hmm. stuff like that. But basically, yeah.
Very exciting. I want to talk about that in a bit because I've begun job searching. I'm a fourth year and thinking
curious about this too, Andrew.
I've been struggling with it.
Are you also going to be doing comedy? What's your major?
That's what I want to do. I'm a computer science major. And that's also been the, do I want a computer science job to just get a computer science job for 3 years and then try to do comedy? Can I get a writing job? Do I just try to do stand up and make videos online? I don't know. And that's been what my brain's been dealing with.
I'm also trying to jump into 100%. I'm trying to pursue a career in comedy and entertainment. I'm curious, Andrew, and like your guys's, I guess, tactics or strategy to like jumping into the entertainment industry. Cause I feel like we all have very similar end goals, but there's so many different ways to reach that goal. So I'm curious to know, like, both of you, especially, wait, Mehr, what year did you say you were?
I'm a sophomore.
Okay. Oh, okay. So you have still time. But I'm still curious to know what you want to do, and Andrew, you too. Like, how you guys are going to tackle the industry.
I don't know. What am I supposed to do?
Just
was it rhetorical?
In the door.
I don't know. I'll figure it out. But we'll get around to that. But what are your end games in comedy? Is it stand-up? Is it what? Podcaster? Talk show? Comedic actress?
Stand-up. Nothing is like, I don't know how to explain it. I've never had the feeling of like performing anywhere else. You know, like I never feel that good. Like after performing and after like a good set, there's no feeling like it. I literally, at the Sexpert show, I performed in front of like 50 people maybe, and everyone laughed at like it was like a very tight set. And then after that, I literally felt like I couldn't feel my body for like a week. I was floating, and it has to be stand up. There's nothing. I want to get a Netflix stand up special and like keep doing that, but it's hard because it's hard. Doesn't happen to a lot of people.
To a lot of sucky people.
Yeah, but guess what? It happens to the dreamers and the believers.
That's the key, is those people weren't dreaming or believing, and that's why they didn't get their
and
Netflix
that's why
special.
They gave up on themselves.
But it's you have so much time. Don't even think about that. Just keep putting the work in right now.
Yeah. It's also like really like interesting because like I was never encouraged to do anything like artsy. Like obviously I was because like my mom like wants me to do whatever I want, but like in my like the education system in India is such that like they never really tell us, oh, you can be a comedian. It's not a thing that you think
of. No one tells you that.
No one tells you that.
Cody told me that. I was like, oh, I could be a comedian, Cody? Oh, interesting.
Great that your mom is so supportive of you pursuing a creative career.
Well, is she? Like, does she know, comedy is what I want to do?
Oh, or does she just want you? Yeah. You made it sound like she was, like, very supportive. Is she not?
No, yeah, she doesn't understand it. Like she's like, oh, Mehr is, like, doing some. She has, like, her meetings and her classes, and I'm, like, it's stand-up meetings, but... And she doesn't really understand. I don't tell her my jokes because most of my jokes are sex jokes, and she can't know that I'm, you know,
I can't have to know jokes. Sooner or later.
I know. I'm not looking forward to that, but I'm going to avoid it as much as I can. So she's never seen me like perform. She's always like heard of it, and she's always like, hey, you should record your Zoom meetings. And I do. And I don't know how to tell her that like I don't want her to see it. I'm like, yeah, I'll look into it. I don't know how to like record.
Yeah.
But I'm sure if she understood, she would be supportive about it. She's starting to understand that, like, I don't want to be, like, a professor, and I want to be a writer, you know, like a comedy
writer. First step, baby steps.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My sister gets it.
That's good. That's some family member. They're like, oh, you want to, okay, that's cool. I mean, oftentimes it's a young person. Yeah. Yeah, I remember.
My sister,
you go ahead.
No, my sister actually like gets it the most because she like is a comedy writer also. She went to Tesh and she worked at Comedy Central. So like she is like a very similar. Yeah.
Very cool.
She worked at Comedy Central? The fuck? How'd she get that bitch?
It is. I don't know how she did it. But yeah.
Wow, it's crazy that both of you like, and your sister are both pursuing comedy writing.
Yeah. She wants to do more like film and television though.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know the feeling of having to come out to your parents as a comedian and having to start to show them your work. Cause after a few years, they're like, show us. And I remember not too long ago, I just had to, and it was a good step for me. It was a good set, but in it, one of the jokes, I referenced me having a boner. And I was like, okay, this is a moment, but they need to know this is it. Click. I emailed it to them so they could watch it alone. My dad responded, pretty funny.
He hit you with the pretty funny.
That's pretty good.
That is pretty good. That sounds like something my dad would say. My dad would probably respond to like mommy sending like a set or a skit with like a random quote from a random movie that's completely irrelevant and off topic that he just thinks is funny. That's how he would respond to it. He'd be like Nacho Libre, and I'd be like, that's not even what I just said. But thank you. That's his way of, I think, congratulating me. I don't know.
That's funny. Very interesting, Mehr, to hear. I'm excited to hear that you want to really pursue it, because most of the people in the club, like even the very funny people, they give the, yeah, maybe, I don't know. Not you. You want to do it.
I want to do it.
It's so much fun.
Like, how could you want to be doing anything else? Like, no offense to all other professions, but what the hell?
I don't get it. I don't get what they're doing.
Doesn't make sense.
How do you feel about writing? Like, when you sit down I love it too. And that's a big key, is loving the writing. Because that's 90% of the work, oftentimes, is writing and editing.
I like it too.
She's a huge fan.
I enjoy it occasionally. No, I do. Writing, yeah, that's probably what I'd want to like my career to be centered around, is writing comedy for sure.
Yeah.
Would you want to be a performer or a writer, Mehr?
Performer.
So it's stand-up. And would you want to do acting? Yeah.
I'm not a good actor, but sure.
I'm in the same. I feel like it's like you can't say like, yeah, I want, like, yeah, I also want to pursue acting, but like low key, I'd be so fucking down. Do you know what I mean? Yeah,
I would love that.
But it's like hard to, but like, I feel like people are like quick to judge if you're like, yeah, and I also want to pursue acting, but like, I'd be fucking down to like act in a comedy show. That'd be amazing. You know what I mean?
For sure. Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, I want to do stand up, but like, if I get like, if I become famous for acting on the way, like, I'm not gonna say no.
Yeah. I feel like it's like the SNL avenue, right? It's like a lot of the SNL people start out as stand up, and then obviously SNL gears them into writing and performing. And then if people like you, then you become like a movie star, like an Amy Poehler or something. So it's just like the natural progression, I feel like.
Go the Amy Poehler route.
I feel like there's not. Yeah, I feel like there's not honestly a lot of comedians that aren't good at that, aren't like, because you know, it's very, you have to be very charismatic, so you're probably naturally better at acting than like the average person.
Yeah.
Let's talk Mehr stand up. So when I mentioned to Michael that we were having you on the show, he told me to ask you how you got everyone to like you so fast. It's a good question, because I don't know it either. And it's just, what's the secret sauce?
Okay, personally, I thought that everyone hated me until like 5 seconds ago.
What?
I don't, it's like, it's the normal, like, every time I meet someone, my first impression is that they hate me. I thought Michael hated me till like ten seconds. I don't know. It's just like, that's just what I think of. Like, I constantly think that I'm making an idiot out of myself, and also like doing stand-up is like making the biggest fool of yourself ever. So I just thought that they hated me. But good to know that people can stand me. That's good.
Definitely not. Also, I would just like to say, I have like the opposite issue. I think everyone just loves me. And then that comes back to me, but the same way as you, because then I just get reality checked all the time. So, but mine goes from like a positive to a negative, but yours goes from like a negative to a positive, which is great for you. Anyways.
Funny. But specifically on your persona, personas are like my kryptonite in stand-up. I still haven't figured them out or mine out, or even to put words to personas. But you had a clear persona from the start. And that is something that's very rare for people even less than a year into stand-up, to just, I don't know, be comfortable in their person telling jokes on stage. So how'd you do it? What are the tips and tricks?
This is really funny because I found out that I had a persona because you guys told me. Mm-hmm. I just thought I was myself. I had mm-hmm. no idea. Like, this is just my personality. I'm just like a weird person who cracks not that great jokes. So I didn't know I had a persona, but I don't know. I just write similar jokes, I guess. Like, I was talking to Jessica about this because we were workshopping some jokes, and she basically was just like, yeah, like, I don't see you as like, you know, a quirky girl who just cracks like sex jokes all the time, but like, I guess that's like your personality. And I was like, is that how people see me?
But I think it's part of your persona is that, I mean, they're not like, I was fucking some pig kind of sex jokes, but they're fun sex goes. Like, you guys want to talk about sex? Let's talk about sex. It's really fun. Yeah, but that definitely has a part of it, but that's not necessarily a bad thing at all.
You think, I'm curious, is there a reason why like sex is your like center for like all of your comedy? Is that like an answer you could share with us? Or is it just like what comes naturally? Like, that's just like your go-to, like,
before you answer that question, I will be sending this podcast to your mom. So just keep that in mind. But
I have never had or thought about sex ever.
Okay. Off the record.
My question is off the record.
Sex is just
now, like, it doesn't really even matter. Funny. Whatever.
Sex is just like a really funny thing to happen. Like, it's so awkward and weird. And like, I don't see a lot of like people or like women talk about sex because it's just like so weird. Like, mm-hmm. who does that? And I just mm-hmm. feel like there's so much like material there because, like, you know, just like situations that are just ridiculously like awkward, like telling your mom that you're sexually active and like that entire situation, or like, you know, just like, it's just such an awkward and like funny thing. And it gets like laughs out of everyone because everyone's like a little bit uncomfortable with it. And like, I love like making people uncomfortable, like with my jokes, because you have that like sense of like the room is like uneasy, but then they laugh because they have no other choice. So
that's interesting for our viewer. Oh, go ahead.
No, Andrew, you said you didn't have a persona, but like, I've watched you in stand-up meetings and I feel like you do. I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm getting better. But I don't know what it is.
I feel like you can't put a name to a persona.
Exactly.
A persona is like
certain personas you can.
Like, you can't.
I think like if you
like
were
what?
To see.
Give me an example.
Well, we could talk about who's a famous stand-up, like John Mulaney's persona. He's flamboyant a little bit. Kind of talks quick. He's a little old-timey.
I feel like your persona is like, you're kind of like schoolboy who doesn't give a fuck, but then like puts like the fake cry and whines. I don't know what, like, I feel like your persona is very, like, childish. Not in a bad
way. I do have a childish. No, yeah, that is true. Yes.
You had this joke.
It's like kid energy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you had this joke where you were just like, trigger warning, I'm going to be talking about my penis in like 30 seconds. And I just thought that joke was so funny. And like, that is like, you're just like a silly, like, I don't know how to explain it, but it's.
Yeah, you're a silly little like, kid yeah. who like knows, who's like too mature for his own good kind of. Yeah. Like that's your persona.
Oh, I like that line. Okay, this was helpful. Thank you. Back to Mehr. So your joke about telling your mom you were sexually active or skirting around telling your mom you were sexually active in the car. It made me think of, I was watching a Dan Harmon talk recently, yesterday. I don't know if you know Dan Harmon. If you don't, it's okay. He's the creator of Community and Rick and Morty. But he was talking about fears and comedy, and talking about your fears is just some of the best material in comedy. I mean, one, it's inherently interesting, and there's funny stuff to be mined there. And it's just interesting hearing someone from a first person perspective say, you didn't say explicitly, this is one of my fears, but this is obviously a scary situation and something that people have feared. And it's cool to overcome it just by hearing the story, like, hey, we got through it. That's cool. And it was funny. That's what I thought of. That's my tale. That was helpful. I don't know if that's a trend in your comedy. I can't think of more bits, but have you found that? Talking about fears or your fears and then jumping off from there?
Yeah, I guess. Like, I think I don't know. What do I even talk about? I'm literally blanking out. Do I even talk?
I know that feeling.
Yeah, but definitely. What are my jokes? Yeah, for this specific joke, it was a very awkward situation. It was really scary, but like the second it happened, I was like, this is going in my stand-up. There's no way this is not going, because it's just like an awkward situation that's like terrifying, but also like it's like so ridiculously funny that it happened. Like, it's so terrifying that it's funny, you know, like how could this have happened to someone? Like, yeah. I had this other joke about how I was sitting in my car with my boyfriend and my aunt, and then like porn started playing on Bluetooth. So that was another like really awkward situation.
What's that story? That actually happened to you?
No, not really. Like, yeah, kind of, but it wasn't my aunt. It was like a driver, but like it was funnier if it was an aunt, and also it was exaggerated.
I love hearing how the sausage gets made. Most people are, you know, it's ruined for me. As a comedian, I'm like, oh, I love hearing that was a made up detail. Cause it's fun. I'm like, oh, she does it too. I do that. Yeah.
That is like when you're writing it. Sorry.
Oh no, keep going.
Yeah, so when you're like writing, you're like, oh, I could add this to make it like a little funnier. But then when you tell someone that, oh, this one detail was added, you're like, they're like, why? Like, why that small thing, like out of the entire freaking show? Mm-hmm. But yeah. Yeah, I'm glad that other comedians like me.
Oh yeah, they do. Louis even talked about that. He was like, he like finished the story and he goes, I made up all that. That was all made up.
I love when stand-up comedians are like candid like that too. Mm-hmm. They're like self-aware, like fourth wall break kind of thing. Mm-hmm. I think it's funny.
What was I gonna ask about? It's something. Oh yeah, one time in meeting, we were giving notes to some new person. I think they stopped coming. But I was like, oh, you could say that blah, blah, blah happened in the story. And they were like, oh, but that didn't happen. I was like, ah, well, you could lie. And then there was like a silence in the room. And I was like, am I the only one who lies? We all lie, right? It was weird.
Yeah, there's no way that literally any, there's no way that any of like the very successful stand-up comedians on Netflix, none of their shit is true. There's no way that anything they say is like real. Like,
I feel like their inspiration comes from like a real incident, and then they just make up a story.
Yes, mm-hmm. Exactly.
Yeah. Let's talk digital content. Mehr is in the video world. You might have seen her on your Explore page on Instagram. She's got, let me pull some up and give the viewers a little bit of what they're begging for. Pull them up. Oh yeah. Here, I'll do it on. Or online.
A little screen sharing action.
I'll do a little screen sharing action. But Mehr, tell us about your endeavors into the digital comedy world.
So I've always wanted to not give a fuck, personally. I just like one day decided to become like public and just post whatever the fuck I wanted. And it has helped me. It was literally therapy to just post whatever I want. And yeah, I just like, I've always like made like really funny, weird videos, but I've always been like, well, my high school thing, but now I just don't care.
Yeah. And who gives a fuck?
Yeah. And also like to become a comedian, I feel like you have to like forget all the people you knew in high school inherently. So that's what I did, yeah. And I just post whatever I think.
That's a good line. To become a comedian, you have to, what did you say exactly? Forget everyone you knew from high school inherently? Yeah. That's funny.
That's why it's a plus that I was homeschooled, guys.
Is this a violation of your trust and privacy?
Okay. It's okay.
It's okay. I should have asked before. I could stop.
Do you want to sign a disclaimer?
You can chat me and the viewers wouldn't know.
I'm okay. I don't care.
That was three okays. No one can say I didn't get
approval. It's on the record, approval. Too.
It's on the record. What's a good, or we'll go to your reels. What's a goodie?
I think that one, like, you can't see
potato?
It. The one next to the washing machine. Yeah, sure. And then the one next to the washing machine.
Here, we'll do that one.
Okay, so it's called Bikini Bottom because it is the bottom part of somebody's bikini. And that is why I think that the entirety of SpongeBob has taken place in the vagina of a dead body that's been stranded in the ocean. Okay, so it's called Bikini
Bottom.
I love it.
To know what was the inspiration behind this one. When did passion strike?
So I was going through my tweets, you know, I stalk myself on Twitter all the time. And I saw a tweet that was just like the bottom part of the bikini is the worst part of the bikini. And then I just thought of Bikini Bottom and then I made this.
Amazing. I think you had a stroke of brilliance.
Thank you.
And oh, I love the filter with it. That was funny. It's just funny and silly. And that's the comedy I like. Stuff that just, it's so silly. Let's watch another. What's another goodie?
The first one I posted is...
So this is a song I wrote about quarantine. Thank you for watching. So
I like
this
that.
Is a song I wrote.
I love that kind of humor, just like quick, right to the point. I like that a lot.
Give us another.
You can watch the potato one.
The what? Oh, the potato one. Nice.
She's eating us again. It's like the sixth time today. Oh, we're gonna go extinct.
Nice.
She's eating us again.
I like it. Very cool. Tell us about your experience making digital content, mentally and creatively.
Mentally, it's all I think about. And like, I do it while I'm supposed to be working. But it has definitely helped me, like, creative, like, it's like another creative, like, output, like, outlet, sorry. Mm-hmm. It's another creative outlet to just, like, you know, there's tweets, and then there's stand-up, and then there's sketch ideas, and then there's digital. You know, there's, like, different ways you can be funny, and mm-hmm. I just thought this was really cool, because, like, filters are super funny, and they're not always supposed to be used to look better, mm-hmm. you know? Like, the washing machine filter, the potato filter isn't supposed to make you look like the Kardashians, but...
Did you
I find love yourself videos too. I it's like I realize that I my creativity strikes the most when I'm like supposed to be doing something else. So I totally relate to you when you said it's like when you should be doing work, your brain's like comedy. That's when my brain turns on like the most with comedies, when I'm supposed to be like taking notes or something. I'm like, well, what if I made like a funny video about like ants? Like, do you know what I mean?
It strikes the most when at like 4 a.m. when I'm right about to sleep, and then I have to get up and like write notes, because I keep going like, I'm gonna remember this. I promise I'm gonna remember this tomorrow, because I don't want to get up and write it down. Yeah. I keep forgetting it. I have to write it down. Yeah.
I'm but like it's that with really annoying. Bits.
Yeah, stand-up bits. Yeah. I literally came up with the entire religion and sex, like the praying and sex is the same. I had a bit where I was talking about that. I came up with that at like 4 a.m. right before my show, like 5 hours before my show. Mm-hmm. And I was like, I'm putting this in.
Mm-hmm. So I feel like a lot of comedians learn the lesson that you will not remember it in the morning. You have to write it down. I mean, that's just a general rule, is you won't assume you will never remember your good ideas. Assume you have to write them down. And I know that because I'll go through my ideas and go, oh yeah, I forgot about that. Yeah.
I realize that I need to be more specific with my ideas, because like I'll have it and like in my mind I have like the entire joke planned out from start to finish. And like, that's so good. And then I was like, well, I'm sure if I write a really vague note on like the subject, there's no way, like it'll just come back to me. And then like a week later, I'll look at like my stand-up notes. One of my stand-up notes is literally, I wish I knew how to beatbox. And I'm reading it and I'm like, what the fuck was my joke here? And I remember thinking and having a whole set for it. And then I read it a week later. I'm like, I don't know where the fuck I was going with that. So yeah, always write
the majority of them. That's relatable. Today in sketch meeting, we did pitches, and Jack Roseman did a pitch. He said, okay, so people are playing Uno, but then someone plays a dose card.
Why is that so good? He's so funny.
He's really funny. Yeah, I believe in that guy so much. And we were like, okay, yeah. So what do you mean by that? And we were arguing over what he meant or where our minds went, and we didn't know. In my head, it was someone playing a card from the game Dose. You know, there's like a separate Dose game.
Yeah.
But other people were thinking it's like a part of the Uno game, but it was a Dose card. I don't know.
I don't know.
He was like, I don't know. I don't know what this is, but.
I love that.
Yeah. This next segment we like to call Gotcha Journalism. Mehr, screenshots have circulated on Twitter of sexually explicit text conversations between you and an underage dog. My question is, how long have you been sexting animals?
Can I be in on the next one? God damn it.
Come on. Absolutely. You can do the next one if you want.
Dog in the screenshot, and also there is no dog.
Twitter trending says otherwise.
Wise Mehr, and honestly, your response is kind of fishy. No pun intended.
So
what do these guys say?
Honestly, they're too vile for us to read on air.
I'd have to agree with Andrew.
But well, we're glad you're finally owning up to what you've done.
First step in recovery.
I just want to say that it was the dog was into it.
Clearly from the screenshots. But is that your excuse? They were underaged and a dog.
Yeah. More importantly, a dog.
A dog. But you know, a young dog.
So a puppy. I was underage too. Okay. I was 17 when it happened.
Oh. Well, Andrew, I think we've got to cut her some slack then.
I think we put this story to rest.
Yeah.
And so concludes our segment called Gotcha Journalism.
Gotcha Journalism. Yep.
You've been got. That's been a running segment of ours, Gotcha Journalism. Grace, take the next one, by all means.
My next Gotcha Journalism?
Next week. But okay, unless you want to You could do another one right now.
I can improv one. Mayor, there has been a lot of talk around town saying that you've been going on carousels and peeing on them and then running. You've been, it's like a hit and run, but you're peeing on the carousel. What do you have to say for yourself? And all the kids sitting in your piss.
And follow-up question, why would you do that?
Why?
So it wasn't on purpose. It just happened. And then I got really shy, and then I just sort of like ran away.
And then you did it to six more carousels?
Yeah,
because the thing is, every time I go on a carousel, I think I can handle the ride, but I can never do, I can never handle it for some reason. So I always end up peeing, and then like the next time I'm like, okay, I'll drink less water. But then on the carousel, I get thirsty, so then I drink water, and then it happens. But yeah, it's not like on purpose. It's completely by accident.
Okay, well,
I forgive her. And I sat in one of the puddles.
Yeah. No. Oh, really, Andrew? Well, I'm sorry to hear that.
I am too. Well, I walked around.
This is like a healing experience for the both of you.
I feel healed. Grace, where are you right now? Maybe we can do some doctor journalism on Grace. Where are you at?
I'm at a friend's apartment.
What's the friend's?
They're all women. It's all close friends of mine. That's why the setup is a little bit different, because this isn't my bedroom, and also this bedroom's way nicer than mine. Look at this paint. Look at this painting. Look how lovely.
I guess my question is, whose computer is that?
So this is my good friend Presley Campbell's computer. And
doesn't sound like a female name.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I guess Presley is a guy name. But it's not, it's a woman. I swear it's a woman. So
interesting how that happens.
Fascinating.
I can have but that's the end of my story. That's the end of my reasoning for that. Anyways, Andrew, how's that lamp behind you? It always piques my interest.
Oh, it's really good. Hey, wait, we're still talking about Grace. You thought you could trick me with my cool lamp. Nice try.
You have such a cool lamp. Andrew, wait, quick, show us your dance moves. Hurry, quick, Andrew, dance moves. Hey.
Man, we have fun. So Mayor, what hey! You tricked me into my cool dance moves.
No.
Okay.
No.
I did not. Let's see.
Mayor, you do not want to see his dance moves.
No, I definitely did want to see that.
Okay. All right.
All right, Andrew, sit back down. It's time to get serious here.
Which song was that? Is that it?
I don't know.
No, wait, that's gonna bother me. And it's a woman voice rapping.
Yeah. What goes around comes around.
It's that song, right?
I don't know.
Is it salt and pepper?
Is it?
Oh, no. Ooh, baby. Ooh, baby, baby. Look up ooh, baby, baby. Ooh, baby, baby. Hip hop song. You have to say hip hop song. Yep.
I'm doing it. Google knows.
And then it should be a woman. um No, I'm looking it up right now. Where's my phone, guys? I'm gonna crack this case. I'm gonna solve this case.
Maybe if we keep the bum 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 bum. This is not it. This is not it at all.
I'm pulling it up right now.
I could go ask people who are living, who are in my living room.
That's gonna wait. Yeah, go quick, quick. Mayor, what kind of music do you like while Andrew's gone?
Oh, that's a rough question. I have no idea. What do I even? Okay, yeah. So the internet, of, and
Charlie. Wait, who's the internet? Is that a band?
Yeah.
Oh, what kind of music?
I said shake it, shake it.
Shake it, shake it. Shake it, shake it. Ooh, baby, baby. Baby, baby, baby. That's going to bother me. I feel like I'm doing a good job singing it, and you're doing a bad job, like, figuring out what I'm singing. Like, I feel like I'm pulling all the weight here.
I feel like I'm about to crack this whole case wide open and you're giving me sass.
I know you're falling in love. No, it is not this.
Maybe we just haven't gotten to the beat drop.
Hold on. It's definitely.
Is it Hey Ya?
Is it Shoop? No. 3,000? I'm on Spotify right now.
Is it Hey Ya?
3,000. It is not Hey Ya. No, it is not. Oh my god, I found it. I found it. Fuck you guys.
What is it?
It's called Push It by Salt and Pepper.
Are they going to take down our video for this? Probably not. We're not running ads.
Yeah. Ooh, baby, baby. Baby, baby. Get to the beat drop. Wait for it. Wait for the beat drop. You gotta wait for the beat drop.
I'm waiting. They're so cool.
I did it. I cracked the code.
Oh, you did that.
Well, that was awesome.
I'm really talented at my, like, I just have a good ear. You're welcome. You're welcome.
So our show is winding down. We just got about 5 more minutes. This has been fun. This one flew by. That's a good sign.
Fly by.
Thank you, let's see. What else?
Wait, I really want to quickly ask, because we never touched on how we were, I don't know if we'll have enough time to cover how y'all are going to tackle trying to get into the comedy sphere, like in the adult world.
Oh, yeah. I don't know. Maybe looked a while last night for like good comedy jobs. I found one that looked really cool. So I applied online and I found the recruiter and I DM'd her on Instagram. Because hey, persistence pays off, and we'll see. So I have one basket and one egg. Yeah,
that's really exciting though.
Yeah, I'm also looking at other non-comedy jobs.
Ooh.
Yeah,
what about podcasts and stuff?
I saw some podcast stuff, but they're more looking for sound engineers. I saw one, they're usually looking for a specialized sound person or like a more senior person, or they're looking for podcast people with followings. And I was like, okay, I got one of those. Yeah, I don't know. It makes me sad. I want to keep putting 40 hours a week into what I really like doing. But I think that might change for a certain time. I don't know. I'm getting smaller in the frame. It's a metaphor.
Are you doing stand-up like in person recently? Because I heard like the improv opened up, like Hollywood improv opened up, and they're doing like social distance shows.
Interesting. I haven't looked into that. Part of me is like, if you're trying to make it happen right now, it should be digital content. You should be on TikTok. You should be on YouTube. And I should get back into that world.
How do people do YouTube? Like, how does that work?
Reddit is the big one to get exposure on. If you get a video, the front page of some subreddit, you snag a couple hundred thousand views, start your base, start growing from there.
YouTube is really tough right now.
It's really
tough. I feel like we're like past the YouTube window, and now it's like really about like short yeah. length comedy right now, unless you're already an established person.
You know, I mean, yes and no. I feel like there are still people who make a great sketch, put it on r/videos, get to the front page. It's hard. If you have an amazing sketch and people love it, that'll get you like 4,000 subscribers at best, which is a jumping off point, but that's if you really hit a home run.
Right. So. I feel like I just look at the views, because I used to be an avid YouTube watcher, subscribe to all the channels, and they would get millions of views, and now all these really popular creators get under 500,000 views in like a week, and then these TikTokers will get like 5 million views in like 24 hours for the shortest little piece of content, you know? So it's interesting how it's
changed. Yeah,
I mean, I don't think people have time anymore. Like, everyone's just so busy like doing other stuff. Like, even if you're on YouTube, you're probably scrolling on Instagram also.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's like super overstimulation.
Yeah.
Sure. Well, this has been a lot of fun. We learned a lot, had some laughs. Had some thinks. And I hope you, the viewer, had some thinks too. I hope we made you go. Yeah,
I hope you're still there.
Hmm?
I hope the viewer's still there and like.
They know. Are. We hooked them this time.
We have a viewer. Maybe we viewers.
Yes.
And we just want to say we did all this for you, the viewer.
For you.
And that we love you.
Yeah, and here's your goodbye kiss.
Mwah.